Spike. Basically today I'm going to be attempting to get a cup of coffee from the little coffee shop that's inside the HSU little depot that they have inside the clock tower. Now, I have been banned from there because I actually had the balls to actually tell one of their employees not to speak to me in a rude manner. The woman was obviously having a bad day. I did not appreciate her attitude, and I told her, hey, you know, you need to be a little bit nicer to your customers. Unfortunately, this university being a training ground for belligerent, willfully ignorant bureaucrats teaches their employees to circle the wagons. So you can be completely... You can be completely correct in telling them to shape up, but they circle the wagons, and so therefore, I mean, they could be completely wrong. They could have the cameras on them showing them that they're wrong, but they'll still be convinced of their own rightness and their own goodness, despite the fact that they are obviously failures in life who need to circle the wagons. Let's go in. I'll just have a large coffee.
Sure. $1.99.
Sure. Thank you.
You're
Well, I did get my cup of coffee because she saw the camera. I opened up the little, you know, I had the little window open so you could actually see it. As I was getting my coffee, I thought I had this on record, but apparently it was on pause. But yeah, she asked me, she said, Mr. Bravo, are you recording? And I, of course, I said, no, I'm not recording. You know, I'm just doing YouTube and don't worry about it. And, you know, this is an object lesson, ladies and gentlemen. This is an object lesson. If you want to intimidate and aggravate idiots and bureaucrats, use a video camera. It's legal and it's more powerful than a gun. Because really it is, because with a video camera, people even see you have a video camera, they start to act on their best behavior, such as the woman in the depot. Now, what I would also like to point out is that when you have a video camera, always make sure you have it on record, if you're recording them. Because a lot of times what the instinct is when they walk up or start asking questions, to just turn it off because you think, oh, they're being compliant. No, no, no. What you do is you keep recording it and then you post it onto YouTube, like I'm going to be doing. As you can see, the University Center and the depot. So, and there's the illustrious clock tower. And of course, all the clocks on campus are off by a few minutes because none of them are synchronized, and that's always an interesting prospect when you're 5 minutes to get across campus to class. But in 2 weeks I won't be here, I won't have to put up with these people, yay! One thing I would like to add in regards to the depot, basically when I went in there, it was just her and there was one other guy who works in the one of the kitchen area parts of it, is they've got the little coffee shop, then they've got the little, you know, sandwich things and, you know, all that other stuff. But see, it was the women that I was having the problem with. And I don't think I put that on YouTube. Maybe I did, maybe I didn't. Anyway, but she was by herself. Now see, the answer that I would have, if it would have been the fact that I was recording that, and when the bureaucrats are by themselves and you have a video camera, if you feel threatened by the bureaucrat or any of the government employee, when they're by themselves, that is particularly a dangerous situation because the bureaucrat will always be believed by other bureaucrats. They stick together. It's a team effort on their part. So when you have a video camera recording a lone bureaucrat, you tell them it is for, quote, my own personal safety to ensure that nothing unethical or illegal occurs, unquote. That's what you say to them because they're always suckers for the safety issue, when in reality you just want to show any inconsistencies and contradictions that they have in their words and actions.